Dear friend, welcome to the video lecture on multidimensional arrays or matrices. In this video lecture, we will be able to learn about matrix reshaping, linear indexing, multidimensional arrays, how to create and manipulate them, accessing the elements, and we can also try to find out the properties like size, dimension, class, etc. Coming to the matrix reshaping, the reshaping stands for reforming the matrix. That is, we will be having an m by n size matrix, and we are converting that matrix into p by q size. For example, let us consider that we have a matrix A here, and here the matrix is having two rows, three columns. Now, by using matrix reshaping, we are going to convert this 2x3 matrix into 1x6 matrix. That means it is going to have one row and six columns. So overall, by using that matrix reshaping, we are going to convert an m by n matrix into a p by q matrix. Coming to the linear indexing, if you have a matrix A having two rows, three columns. Now, if we wish to access this element, then we can go for this kind of indexing, that is A of 1, 2, where 1 indicates the first row, 2 indicates the second column, so that we can access 2. And if we wish to access the 6, then we have to go for second row and third column. So A of 2, 3 can be written so that we can access that element six. In the same way, by using single indexing also, we can access the matrix elements in MATLAB. Like whenever we enter the matrix into the MATLAB environment, then the MATLAB is going to store the elements column wise. That means first it stores 1, 4, then later it goes to 2, 5, later it goes to 3, 6. So column wise appending will be done, and they will be arranged vertically as shown in this figure. So here all the matrix elements are arranged column wise. So 1, 4, then 2, 5, then 3, 6. Now these elements will be given the position indexes. That means in first position 1 is stored, in second position 4, third 2, fourth 5, fifth 3, and sixth is 6. Now, if we wish to access them with a single indexing, then in order to access these two, you can write A of 3. So here, if we write A of 3, then we can access the 2 which is stored in the third location. And if we want to access the element 6, then we have to write A of 6 so that we can access that 6th element. So if we take the single indexing and try to access the elements in the matrix, then we call that one as linear indexing. Now coming to multi-dimensional arrays. So we have a two-dimensional array. Two-dimensional array means it is going to have two dimensions. One is row, another one is column, right? So if you look at any two-dimensional matrix, we'll be having row as well as the column, right? So this is the example of one or two-dimensional matrix where these are rows. That means three rows are there, and here these are columns, and there are three columns are available, right? And this is the format of indexing. That means we are going to write A of row, comma, then column, so that particular element which is located in those locations can be easily accessed. Now, coming to the multidimensional arrays. In the multidimensional arrays, along with the rows and columns, we will be having page, etc. So if you look at a simple 3D, we can write like this. So first index indicates row, second index indicates the column, third index indicates the page. That means if we look at this figure, so this is the first page. So this page contains a particular matrix here, and this is the page 2. There we are also having the matrix, and let us consider this one as the page 3. Now, in order to indicate any one of the element, for example, if we wish to access the element 9 here, then what we have to do is, let us consider this entire thing is represented by the variable A. So I can write here A of, right? So here it is a second row and third column. So I can write second row, then third column, then it is in page 2. So I have to write 2 so that this indication goes to 9 so that I can access the 9. So like that, how many pages that are there? Those many pages elements can be easily accessed by using this kind of indication. If there are n number of pages within this, then the common index will be like this. A of index 1, index 2, index 3, index n. If the variable is indicated with capital A and indicated with small a, both are not same and they are different since MATLAB is a case sensitive programming language. So I just consider a small a, and here you can go for small a here in order to match these examples, right? So in case of a three-dimensional array, so I can write a small a of index 1, index 2, index 3. So the first one indicates the row, second one indicates the column, and third one indicates the page. And if I have four dimensions, right? So in that case, what we can do is, let us consider different bundles. So this is the like a paper bundle. So in that paper bundle, there are so many papers. So this is first page, and then second page, then third page. Like that, n number of pages will be there. So each page is going to have their own matrices. For understanding purpose, we just consider like that. Then go to bundle 2. The same thing will be there, bundle 3 and bundle 4. We can assume the same thing. That means every bundle is going to have a certain stack of papers, and all the papers will be of same size. That means if you look at any matrix here, all the matrices in that particular bundle will be having the same number of elements with the same matrix dimensions, right? So keep that in mind. Now, so in this case, if I want to wish to access this 11 in bundle 2, right? So then, and also we are considering that page as page 3, right? So here this 11 is indicated within first row, then second column, then page 3 of bundle 2. So I can write, this is first row, second column, third page, second bundle. So if I indicate this, then I can access the element 11 in that multi-dimensional arrays or matrices. And also we'll be having a special instruction which is called as permute. So this permute is like transposing the matrix. So in case of a two-dimensional matrix, if you have a matrix A, then in order to find out its transpose, we are going to keep apostrophe or a quote, a single quote on top of that A, so that it indicates the transpose of a matrix, right? And in case of multi-dimensional arrays, we call that one as short MDA. In case of multi-dimensional arrays, we have to consider the permute. So this permute will interchanges the dimensions of rows and columns. That means rows becomes columns, columns becomes rows. And in whatever we just wanted to keep our matrices, in the same way, you can keep your matrix, right? Now, let us see certain problems in multi-dimensional arrays or matrices, how we can handle in MATLAB environment. So let me open the MATLAB. Right. So I just open the MATLAB. So here I will type a matrix, and let us consider it is a 2x3 matrix. 1, 2, 3, first row, 4, 5, 6, second row. So it is having two rows and three columns. Now I can reshape this. In order to reshape that, so reshape of A matrix with, I just wanted to keep this as three rows with two columns. So by using that command reshape, that matrix A, which is having two rows and three columns, can be now converted into three rows and two columns. Or even I can change this one to, so reshape of A into one row, then six columns. So there is one row and six columns, right? Then if I want to reshape this matrix of A 3x3, that means three columns and three rows, then we will get the error. Why? Because while reshaping the matrix, you have to concentrate on how many number of elements are present there. So basically, there are 6 elements in the matrix, but we are trying to reshape that matrix into a 9 element matrix, so which is not possible. So how many number of elements are there in the matrix, that number of matrix elements you have to keep in your mind. Accordingly, that you can rearrange the matrix. So keep that in your mind. Let clear the screen. Right. So coming to the multi-dimensional arrays, how we can create those multi-dimensional arrays? So let us consider a matrix 3x3. The elements are 1, 2, 3. Then 4, 5, 6, then 7, 8, 9. Okay. So, anyhow, before going to that, let me talk about the linear indexing, right? So, if I type, if I want to access the element 6, so that is in second row and third column. So, second row, then third column, I can access 6, right? At the same time, I just wanted to convert that entire matrix into linear index by using that colon operator. So everything will be now converted into vertically arranged format. And if you look at the positions of the elements, so 1, 4, 7, then 2, 5, 8, 3, 6, 9, we have to consider. So 1, 2, 3, then 4, 5, 6, then 7, then 8. So in the 8th position, the 6th element is there. Right, so I can type A of 8 with a single indexing. I call that one as linear indexing. So if I type A of 8, then I can access 6. So this we call as a linear indexing. Now we will try to generate the multi-dimensional matrix or arrays. So let us consider a matrix A now. So it is a 3x3 matrix taking elements of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then 7, 8, 9. Okay, now I just wanted to give one more page to that. So for that, I have to keep same number of rows, same number of columns, and page 2 I'm creating. So in the page 2, what are the elements that I want to keep? I just wanted to keep 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2, then 3, 3, 3. So this is also a 3x3 matrix. And this matrix is there in the second page. Now I want to create a third page also. Then what should I do is, I have to keep the same number of rows, same number of columns, then page 3. Right? Then I can give what are the elements that I want to give. I just wanted to give the identity matrix here. So 1, 0, 0, then 0, 1, 0, then 0, 0, 1. I just wanted to give this one. Okay, so there is a bundle. In that bundle, there are three pages, and each page is containing these kind of 3x3 matrices. Okay, right. I just wanted to create a seventh page. For example, A of equal number of rows, equal number of columns, and a seventh page I just wanted to create. So three pages are having the elements, and I'm going to keep the matrix for seventh page. Okay. So here also I just wanted to give 1, then 4, then 5, then 6, 5, then 3, then 8, 9, 9, 0, then 1. This is a matrix that I have given. Now you can observe here, up to page 3, what are the elements that have entered, it is considered. Then 4th page takes all zeros, 5th page also takes all zeros, 6th page also takes all zeros. But when entered for 7, those entered elements are present in that matrix. That means whenever we are skipping the lower level pages, then automatically they will be assigned with all zeros. Keep that in mind. So this is one of the ways to represent the multi-dimensional arrays. At the same time, by using certain built-in functions, we can also create the multi-dimensional arrays. For example, if I want to generate a matrix with random numbers. So if I type only rand, that may deal with the two-dimensional arrays or matrices. And coming to the multi-dimensional arrays, I just wanted to give one more letter n. So rand n, now this rand n gives the values between 0 and 1, and I just wanted to create the random matrix of multi dimensions of 4 rows, then 3 columns, then 2 pages. That means there are 4 rows and 3 columns, and those kind of matrices with the different values will be there in 2 pages, page 1 and page 2. Let us see that. Okay, so there are 2 pages having 4 rows and 3 columns at the same time. I can also generate a matrix with all values zeros. So zeros, at the same time I can go for 3 rows, 4 columns and 4 pages. That means there will be 4 pages of 3 rows and 4 columns having all zeros. So here you can observe that. So first page, so 3 rows and 4 columns are given here, and this is page 1, then later page 2, then page 3, then finally page 4. Also, if you want to create ones, then you have to type ones of how many rows that we want? 5 rows. Then if you want to keep 4 columns, that you can. If you want to print them in 3 pages, then you have to give 3. Then you can observe here. There are 5 rows, 4 columns of 3 pages. And not only this, by using concatenating operation, we can also create the multi-dimensional arrays here. And the concatenation command that we have to use is cat. C-E-C-A-T. Let us clear the screen now. So here I will type A. So it is the variable name. Then cat. Now I just wanted to create the 3D, three-dimensional array. And I'm giving the elements as 9, then 2, then 6, 5. Next one, other elements are 7, 1, then 8, 4. So we can observe here. So we just created a three-dimensional array. So in that we have consider 2 rows, 2 columns. Such kind of pages are 2. And also we can create a 4-dimensional array. So here concatenate command, that is cat of 4 dimensions having 3, 5, then 0, 1, then 5, 6, then 2, 1. So these are the elements that I just wanted to give to the pages there. So here, there are 2 rows, 2 columns, page 1, bundle 1. Okay. And here, in the same way, there are same number of rows, same number of columns, and there is page 1, there is a bundle 1. Then we can go for page 2. So here 4 dimensions means that whatever the indices that we are writing in the bracket, those indicates. In case of 3 dimension, we have 3 indices, and in case of 4 dimension, we just have indicated the 4 indices. So that is the meaning for that. Now, so how can we access the elements in this case? Okay, so let us clear the screen now. Again, I will enter a matrix. Let us consider that variable as E. Then I just wanted to give the matrix as 1, then 2, 3, then 4, 5, 6, then 7, 8, 9. So let us consider this is the matrix. And I want to give the second page also. So in the second page, I want to keep same number of rows, same number of columns, then page 2. And I'm giving the values as 1, 1, 1, then 2, 2, 2, then 3, 3, 3. Okay, so I have created the page 2 also, and even I can go for page 3 with the same number of rows, same number of columns. That means all rows and all columns. And page 3, and giving the values such as 1, 0, 0, then 0, 1, 0, then 0, 0, 1. Let us consider this matrix. So these are the various pages. Now I just wanted to access the 9, which is in page 1. So the 9 is located at third row and third column of page 1. So I can give E of 3, 3, 1. So that I can access 9 there. Even with single index, if we want to access, then we can type E of 9 so that we can access the element 9. Now, if we want to access the 2, which is in the middle of the second row of page 2, right? So in that case, how can I do that? So I should go for second row, then second column of page 2. So if I type that, I will get, or I can access 2. Not only a single element, I can also access the entire row. If I want to access the entire row, then I have to go for E. Then I want to access the second row, right? And the elements are there within the all columns. So I have to type all columns. Then it is in page 2. Then I can access that entire row. And the same thing can also be written like this. So E of second row, and columns are from 1, 2, 3. Then it is page 2. Same answer. I can get that triple 2. Okay. Now, in the page 3, if I wish to access 010 and 001, for example, 010 and 001. So in order to access this, what should I do is, I have to consider the second row and third row and all the columns of page 3. So then I can go for E of second row to third row, then all columns, then page 3. So I can access 010, 001 like that. So this is the way of accessing the various elements in the multi-dimensional arrays. Now, how we can manipulate these multi-dimensional arrays? That means if I want to generate a matrix with all the elements which are equal to 2. So at each and every position, if I want to keep 2 with 3 rows, 2 columns and 2 pages, then how can we do? And we consider this one as manipulation of multi-dimensional arrays. In order to do that, let us clear the screen once again. Right. I just wanted to create that matrix. So what the command that we have to use is repmat. That means repeat matrix. So let us consider the variable as A. And here I'm typing repeat mat. That means it copy that matrix based on the dimension what we are providing here. So repeat matrix, then that matrix should contain a constant value, and that constant value that I consider as 2, that means I want to print only 2 and no other element will be present, and width 3 rows, 2 columns with 2 pages, right? There are 3 rows, 2 columns, and I have page 1 and page 2. And also, if I want to keep 5, then I will take one more variable, then repeat mat, that means rep mat. I want to keep the constant value 5. Then I have to mention the dimensions. Then there are 2 rows, 2 columns, and 5 pages with 2 bundles. That I can check here. So all the constant values have been changed to 5, having 5 rows, having 2 rows and 2 columns in bundle 1 as well as the bundle 2, and having different pages, right? Let us clear the screen once again. Now we would like to change the dimensions of the matrices that we are going to use the permute command here. So once we use the permute here, then all the dimensions of the multi-dimensional matrices will be changed, and they will be interchanged. We can say, for example, we take one example here. Let us consider matrix C here. And let us consider the elements as 1, 2, 3, then 4, 5, 6, then 7, 8, 9. So this is the matrix that is there in the first page, and it is a 3 by 3 matrix. Now I just want to give the second page. So all columns, all rows, second page is having these elements. The elements here I just consider is 0, 5, 4, then 2, 7, 6, then 9, then 3, then 1. So these are the values that I have considered. Now I am typing that permute. So D equal to permute. I have to transpose the dimensions of the matrix C here. So I have to type C. Then I have to provide the dimensions as then 2, then 1, then 3. So what the answer that you may expect here? Remember, while using the permute instruction or command, we have to provide the dimensions in which order we want to print. For example, if you see the matrix C here, the first dimension is row. There are three rows. And the second dimension is column, three columns. And there are two pages. Okay. So in order to indicate this matrix, what we can do is we have to type C of, then it is containing three rows, three comma, three columns, then two pages, three comma two, that we can type. Now, if you wish to, now here, that three comma two will be indicated with position one, position two, position three, right? So here in permute, what are the numbers that I'm typing here? Those are the position numbers, and in which order that we want to print those position numbers only, right? Now what we can, how we can understand this permute of C comma 213 is that previously this one is the dimension of the row, and two is the dimension of the column, three is the dimension of the pages, right? Now what are the position values that they were previously indicated, right? Those values, with those values that matrix now will be printed. For example, previously here the dimension value is 1, whose value is 3. Now second dimension is 2, whose value is 3. Now the 2 dimension came in rows, right? So 2 refers to 3, 3 columns there. Now those 3 columns will turn into 3 rows, right? Then 1 is here. Previously this 1 is the dimension of rows. There the rows are 3. Now here also they just converted into 3. Now the third position is, as this. So in this case, how many pages that we have? 2. So here also we are going to have 2 pages only, right? So there are 2 pages with the interchanging of the rows and columns of the matrices. And in order to understand this again, we go for one more the permute operation. So let us consider that variable as again D. So here I'm typing permute, and this permute has to be performed on the matrix C. Now the order I'm giving as 3, then 2, then 1, right? Now again, remember, while we are indicating the matrix C, it is having 3 rows, 3 columns, and 2 pages. So 1, 2, 3 is the dimension order that we have given. So 1 stands for 3, 2 stands for 3, and 3 stands for 2, right? So in the same way, here 3 is there. So 3 stands for 2. That means 2 rows will be there. 2 stands for 2. That means 3 columns will be there. And 1 stands for 3. That means 3 pages will be there. So here we'll be having the same result. Okay? So this way, the permute will function on the multi-dimensional arrays in order to interchange the rows and columns of the multi-dimensional array. Now, we can also identify the dimensions. In order to identify the dimensions, we have to use n dimes. It indicates the n dimensions. And for that C, if you type, then we can get the dimension of that particular matrix C is 3. It's a 3-dimensional. Why? Because there are rows, columns, then a page is indicated. No bundle was there. That's why it is 3. Now, even if you want to find out the size of that particular C, there we can identify. So there are 3 rows, 3 columns, 2 pages. So this way, we can also find out the pages or the properties of the multi-dimensional arrays. Hope you understood the basics of how to handle the multi-dimensional arrays using the MATLAB. So if you understand all the concepts, please do like, comment, share and subscribe my channel if you do not do that so far. So thanks for watching.